centers in your brain, which can dramatically change your perception of reality for 3 to 12 hours, depending on the drug and the dose and the person. But Albert Hoffman didn't know any of this when he decided to test LSD on himself in 1943. In 2014, researchers mapped what's happening in the brain during a trip. This is a representation of a normal, sober brain. These dots are different regions of the brain, and these lines are the connections. And here's what the tripping brain looks like. Regions that wouldn't usually talk are now in lively conversation.
One can't help but wonder whether in this period of extreme interconnectivity that there isn't a potential for rewiring or making new connections. And that's an attractive but very speculative hypothesis about why these effects might be so enduring.
That you can think of your mind as a snow-covered hill, and your thoughts are sleds. A path is pressed into the snow. It gets deeper and deeper, and soon it's hard to escape that groove. A psychedelic trip is the fresh snowfall that lets your sleds explore a new path. That could mean changing an ingrained behavior, like an alcohol or cigarette addiction.
Depression and anxiety are very much like addictions.
People in depression and anxiety are often in this ruminating pattern.
You're getting stuck in loops of thought. You're getting stuck on narratives of who you are.
The brain circuitry responsible for constantly mulling over the past and future, creating this narrow sense of self, is the default mode network. This seems to be the seat of the ego.
In depression, activity in the default mode network is increased, and it's decreased acutely with a drug like psilocybin.
By dissolving the ego, you may dissolve the hold of those narratives on people. You know, that you're not identical to this annoying, chattering voice in your head.
These are less well-controlled studies, but they seem to show very significant and enduring effects.
People who've been suicidal, people who've been hopeless, self-loathing, and then come in and see this smiling. Since I went home and I walked into my house and I started crying with joy, that they now see who they really are.
We're still a ways off from psychedelics being prescribed outside clinical trials. Much more research needs to be done. These drugs are unique. More than any pharmaceutical on the market, the effects of these compounds depend on where you take them, who you take them with, and what you want them to do.
I don't think these drugs are right for everyone, but for a great many of us, I think they offer potential.
I had one experience where I died, and I was pretty sure that where I was just death. Like, this is what being dead must be like, and it's not that bad. So why am I so afraid? And that was very powerful, because I sort of made the choice not to let it affect me. And I've been different ever since, in a good way.